Raquel and Brady's stolen house back porch party. She's house sitting, and then we played a party. And then we played two shows in one night. We played the party, and the cops busted it. We were really glad because we had a gig at George's, and then we quickly packed up all our equipment and went out to George's and played. And we were horrible on the back porch, mainly due to a PA problem, and we were incredible at George's. Felt very good about it.
It basically at first was my songs and Michael's songs, you know, kind of like a mix of those, and kind of picked from the ones that we wanted to play. And then we started writing things together recently.
I would say not at first. I think that now, of late, I think I'm starting to come into my own with the band and everything.
We do some Morrissey songs. We do one Morrissey song. We do a Smith song. We do a Beatles song. And we do Willie Bragg. And what else? That's about it, isn't it?
No, Robin Hitchcock.
Robin Hitchcock.
Psychedelic Furs.
Oh God, we haven't played that in a long time. That's not even on my list.
History. I mean, we all have big musical influences, and then maybe the Beatles, I guess, because they were a very predominant thing. But I mean, I don't sit there and say, I mean, like influences, like as far as like what really engulfed my life and records that I bought, the Beatles. But like what I try and sound like, I can't tell you that it would be like the Buzzcocks or something. Whereas, you know, the Beatles were more of an effect.
My biggest influences, music-wise, would range from
bebop
jazz, through the Beatles, through Brahms, through early '80s English
post-punk. Post-punk was my biggest era, probably. The way I sound, I think I sound like post-80s, post-punk.
Well, in the early days, I guess my biggest influence was probably like Lou Reed, but and I like a lot of hardcore. That's what got me playing the guitar. And then I quit kind of out of the hardcore kind of scene, and I stuck with Lou Reed. And then recently, probably in the past 2 years, my biggest and favorite band would be the Smiths and Morrissey. We shove our three faces on MTV and let every little kid buy our records.
I end up on the morning paper of everybody's table that hates me, shining my snotty little grin out into their breakfast.
Just to be able to be placed in a position financially where we could do where I could do this all the time, that I would let it pay for itself and then some.
We'd like to thank no one.
I don't, for nothing.
Nobody. Nobody. No one thing. No one thing.